About the epicyclic gear train in detail. So the basic definition is that the gear which moves upon and around the other gear is called as epicyclic gear train. So now let us draw the diagram for the representing it. So now consider two gears, one small one and the other large one, with the centers fixed the direction of rotating clockwise and the other anti-clockwise. Now let me show you, or let us introduce a arm. It's also called as a mechanical arm. It is usually a link to join the two gears such that the one gears can rotate around the other gears. So this is the planet. The one is planet gear and the other is sun gear. And here it is an arm represented at A, planet represented at P, and sun represented as, drawing the corresponding side view of these gears representing chess. Where the input shaft is this, and a mechanical arm is connected from here to the output shaft. So let it resemble as arm. This is the bigger gear, the smaller gear, smaller gear, and writing the input and output, input and output. So here we have drawn a corresponding side view of this diagram. This is the sun, sorry, planet. This is the sun. This is the mechanical arm. Now there are various conditions which we have to keep in mind. If arm A is fixed, then P and S will form as P and S gears will form a simple gear train. So you can see that if we fix the arm A, there is no relative motion between with respect to each other on the outer surface. It can be moved here only, this at part only, between the two mating parts. So it is called as a simple gear train. The second condition is that if sun gear is fixed and the planet is free to rotate over the sun, then this condition or working system would be called as epicyclic gear train. So now if we rotate this planet gear over the sun gear the help of mechanical arm, then this condition is said to be a epicyclic gear train condition. Now let us see the sine convection. So if gears rotate in clockwise direction, then it is usually taken as positive. And if gears rotate in counterclockwise, it is taken as negative. You can see that clockwise it is usually referred as like this, and counterclockwise usually referred like this. I explain you the table method to find the velocity ratios. So in order to find the velocity ratio, we have to first draw the table. Table look like this. First of all, serial number or row. The second is operation to be done. The third is revolution of arm A, the next revolution of gear P, revolution of gear S, where P and S are planet and sun, gear and A is the arm. Now, so that you can see this, that here planet, sun and arm, gears and rod. So if we fix the planet gear, arm A is fixed. So if arm A is fixed and planet gear is given one revolution, we can write like this. Number one, arm A fix and planet gear plus one revolution, which can be written as, since revolution of arm A is fixed, it is zero. The revolution of gear P is given plus one, so writing plus one. And now here writing the revolution of gear S, this would be the ratio of teeth on P to that of the teeth on sun. And since the sun is rotating in counterclockwise, we substitute it as negative. Now from point 2, we have to just multiply first row by x, and the third one is add y to the first, sorry, second. Now you can see if we add, since multiplying x to 0 is just 0, here it will convert to x and here it will get convert to minus theta of planet to that of the theta of sun into x. Now as third step is that adding just y. Now here adding y, it will convert to y. Here x plus y, and here it will get convert to y minus tp by ts into x. Now these are the basically equations which you can stimulate to get the answers of the epicyclic gear train. So by applying the following equations, you can find the parameters required. Now just partitioning them along so that you don't get messed up with this all. Here, if there are n number of gears, or 1 or 2 or 3 gears linked to a single arm which gets rotated, the same phenomena can be used, or the procedure, in order to derive the equations and the parameters which is required. Thanks for watching.